Turn to textbook page 145, Gregor 5.1, the locally particle A&S. Now, I'm going to talk about the particle A&S, which looks similar because these two particles are referred to as locally particle in that both particles attach to location. However, there is a major difference between these two particles. First of all, I'm going to start with this particle low, locally particle A, which we have learned in grammar 3.1 when you learned how to express the location. So, how to describe the location of the book? The book is on the desk. How to say that? 책이, the book is 책이 책상 위에 있어요. Notice that this locally particle is used with this verb 있어요 and it's indicating the location and it's attached to the place, location. So that's what is called a locally particle. And the a can be associated with many different functions. And a also used with directional verbs such as 가다, to go, 오다, to come, and also 다니다, to attend, come and go regularly. So, like directional verbs, and it indicates destination or goals. Here's an example. And I want to say, okay, like her name is Sandy. Sandy goes to school. 학교에 가요. So as you can see here, A is attached to a destination where she's going. 학교 is the destination. 학교에 가요. So as you can see here, A is attached to like a place. With the verb, directional verb, 가요, 오다, 오다. And it's more like an English compatible preposition like to, go somewhere, 학교에 가요. And this locally particle can be omitted in colloquial speech as long as context does not make the meaning less clear. In particular, the locally particle A is often deleted when used together with a question word. Here's an example. So let's say someone is asking, where are you going? And notice that A is attached to question where, 어디. 어디에 가요? Where are you going? 어디 가요? So oftentimes this A is omitted. 어디 가요? 도서관에 가요. So notice that when you use this verb, 가다, you attach A to the destination. 도서관에 가요. 어디 가요? 백화점에 가요. I'm going to a department store. Now I'm going to talk about this particle 에서. And this is also referred to as locally particle. It is used to indicate the location of activity. Refer to a dynamic location because the action or activity take place in that location. So notice that you try to describe that someone is studying the library. And you can say, okay, Sandy가 도서관에서 공부해요. So use this verb like activity verb. So when someone is engaged in some kind of activity and that activity is taking place some location, you add 에서 to that place. 도서관에서 공부해요. So this particle is similar to English preposition like at or in. 도서관에서 공부해요. She's studying at the library. 도서관에서 공부해요. So when there is a dynamic location, then you add 에서 instead of 에. Look at the picture and say what each person is doing and where. She's studying at her room, 방, room, 방에서 공부해요. 백화점에서 쇼핑해요. She's shopping where? 백화점, at the department store. 백화점에서 쇼핑해요. 커피숍에서 친구를 만나요. 커피숍에서 커피를 마셔요. So meet someone or drink something. These are all physical activity verbs. And then those kind of activity take place in a certain location, and 에서 is attached to that location. 커피숍에서. However, 가다, although this is a more like activity, but this is exception. When you use this verb to go, you always add to location. 학교에서 한국어를 공부해요. Someone is studying Korean where? 학교, at the school. 학교에서 공부해요. 방에, however, static location such as 있어요, then you add a. 집에서 피아노를 연습해요. So she's studying, practicing, 연습하다, practicing piano at home. 집에서 피아노를 연습해요. 헬스 클럽, 헬스장에서 운동해요. Exercising at the health club. Office에서 일해요. Working at the office. 골프코트, 골프장에서 골프를 쳐요. Playing golf at the golf club. Now, I wanted to add an에서 probably. 집에서 비디오 게임을 해요. Someone's playing video game at home. 집에서. 도서관에서 책을 읽어요. Someone is reading a book at the library. 도서관에서. Someone's drinking coffee at cafe. 카페에서 커피를 마셔요. 집에서, 방에서 전화를 해요. 방에서 자요. Please add an에서 학교에 가요. So because the verb is 가다, you add a. 가방에 있어요. Because the verb is 있어요, you add a. 집에서 텔레비전을 봐요. Because you use this verb, the physical activity 보다, the location, you add 에서. 카페에서 신문을 읽어요. Someone is reading a newspaper at cafeteria. 랩에서 들어요. 들어요 means to listen. So you add 에서. 도서관에서 자요. 자요 is also considered as an activity. So you add 에서. Now, fill in the blanks with the appropriate particle 에 and 에서. Please be careful what the verbs are used. Number one, 마크가 커피숍 에서 공부해요. 유미가 서점에 가요. The verb is 가다. 리사가 커피숍에 있어요. Because the verb is 있어요. You add 에. 소피아가 백화점에서 쇼핑해요. 제니가 캠퍼스에서 친구를 만나요. 부모님이 일본에 계세요. So when the verb is static verb such as 있어요. 계세요, 가요, you add 에. So, in summary, if it's a location of existence, static location, then you add 에. Destination or goal, with a directional verb, you add 에. Before a dynamic verb, then you add 에서. 어디에서 선물을 사세요? 선물이 생일 선물을 어디에서 사세요? Where do you buy a birthday gift? 백화점에서 사요. 어디에서 커피를 마셔요? 스타벅스에서 마셔요. 어디에서 책을 사요? Where do you buy your books? 서점에서 책을 사요. 어디에서 점심을 먹어요? Where do you eat your lunch? KFC에서 점심을 먹어요. Now I'm just gonna add some question to you and please answer. 보통 집에서 뭐 하세요? Usually 보통 what do you do at home? 집에서 자요? 집에서 먹어요? 집에서 공부해요. Maybe those kind of the answer be appropriate. 보통 커피숍에서 뭐 하세요? Usually, what do you do at a coffee shop? 커피숍에서 커피를 마셔요. 점심을 먹어요. 친구를 만나요. 공부를 해요. 도서관에서 뭐 하세요? 도서관에서 공부해요. 책을 읽어요. 친구를 만나요. 숙제를 해요. 공원에서 뭐 하세요? 공원에서 I walk, 걸어요. 공원에서 커피를 마셔요. 공원에서 exercise, 운동을 해요. I wanted to turn to textbook page 147, exercise 1. 어디서 공부해요? 도서관에서 공부해요. 어디 가세요? 한국어 수업에 가요. 한국어 교실은 어디에 있어요? 유니언 빌딩에 있어요. 어디서 한국어를 연습해요? 랩에서 연습해요. 컴퓨터 랩은 어디에 있어요? 유니언 빌딩에 있어요.